This is the book of Isaiah, chapter 60, and verse 1. Arise, shine, for thy light is come, and the glory of the Lord, Yahweh Bashem, Yahweh Shai, is risen upon thee. All praise goes to Yahweh Bahashem, Yahweh Shai, Waha Rakah Kwedash. Double honors to the apostles and elders of the great millstone. Also, peace and blessings to the hopeful elect. Lord willing, this lesson will be edifying. Isaiah 60 and verse 1 again. Arise, shine, for thy light is come, and the glory of the Lord, Yahweh Bashem, Yahweh Shai, is risen upon thee. And we have the glory of the Lord that has been risen upon us, being a part of the believers. First of all, we have the gift of faith, which gives us the capability to trust, believe, and hope within a hopeless generation, within this gross darkness. As verse 2 tells us, for behold, the darkness shall cover the earth, and gross darkness the people. And that darkness has been brought forth by a dark man, starting with the wicked elites of the so-called modern-day white race, which are the Edomites. They're bringing forth their light, which is darkness, which is misinformation. The scripture says, and gross darkness the people, meaning you Israelites, you so-called Negroes, Latinos, and Native Americans. Esau Edom has blinded you and made you to believe that you are Negroes, Latinos, and Native Americans, on down to so-called Mexicans. He have made you believe in his image that he have given you to be your savior. Now, the scripture tells us in the book of 2 Corinthians chapter 4 and verse 3, it says, but if our gospel be hid, it is hid to them that are lost. And 2/3 of our people are lost in the sauce, so to speak. Going back to the book of Isaiah 60 and verse 2, for behold, the darkness shall cover the earth and gross darkness the people. But the Lord, Yahweh Bashem, Yahweh Shai, shall arise upon thee. And that's the hopeful elect in our case, those that have the gift of faith to believe here in a faithless generation, where the time where incredulity is at its highest. It says, and his glory shall be seen upon thee. And what's one example of that glory? We are coming up out of that dust. We're standing upon our feet due to the light and prophesying against Mount Seir. And we're proclaiming to be the true children of the Most High, which we are. And that's only by the light. That's why the book of St. John, chapter 1, and verse 4 tells us, in him was life, and the life was the light of men. So we having the true life, all right? Not just waking up in a 24-hour period, which Esau Edom gives us. I'm talking about spiritual life, because 2/3 of our people are amongst the living dead, because they don't have that true life, which is receiving that light. Who is that light? Our Lord and Savior, Yahweh Shai. Verse 5 tells us, and the light shineth in darkness, and the darkness comprehended it not. And that's 2/3 of our people. They can't comprehend this truth. They can't receive this truth. Back to 2 Corinthians 4 and verse 3 again. But if our gospel be hid, it is hid to them that are lost, in whom the God of this world have blinded the minds of them which believe not. And that's a gauge that the Most High have set up. He have given us faith, which is a gift, which gives us the capability to believe, hope, or trust. But he have deprived 2/3 of our people of that gift. And the power of this world, or the God of this world, which is Esau, have blinded them and made them to believe a lie. It says, lest the light of the glorious gospel of Hamashiach, see that, Yahweh Shai being that light, who is the image of the Most High, should shine unto them. For we preach not ourselves, but Hamashiach, Yahweh Shai, the Lord, and ourselves your servants for Yahweh Shai's sake. Verse 6, for God who commanded the light to shine out of darkness, that's us coming out of that confused state, have shined in our hearts, being the hopeful elect, those that have received that gift, to give the light of the knowledge of the glory of the Most High in the face of Yahawashah HaMashiach. Verse 7, it says, and this is the glory, or one example of the glory of the Most High, but we have this treasure, meaning this truth, in earthly vessels, that the excellency of the power may be of the Most High and not of us. That's why the Most High have chosen the weak things of the world. 1 Corinthians chapter 1 and verse 25, it says, because the foolishness of the Most High is wiser than men, and the weakness of the Most High is stronger than men. And we would be the weakness of the Most High, which is stronger than Esau Edom, because we are using that light, which is Yahawashah, to bring down this system, which is a spiritual fight. Verse 26, for ye see your calling, brethren. And how do we know we have been called? Because we have the gift of faith, and that gives us the capability to hope, believe, and trust. And we also have understanding and fear. That's how you know you've been called. It says, how that not many wise men after the flesh, not many mighty, not many noble are called. Verse 27, but the Most High have chosen the foolish things of the world to confound the wise. And that is an example of the glory of the Most High being seen upon us. And the Most High have chosen the weak things of the world to confound the things which are mighty. And we will be the weak things. All right. And Esau, Edom, starting with the wicked elites, are the mighty. Job 9 and 24, the earth has been given into the hand of the wicked. So they are in control. But we have no power in our hands, only the power of this word, which is thy sword of the Most High. And we're using this sword to bring down Esau Edom's system. And the Most High have chosen weak things of the world to do that. That's one example of the glory of the Lord being seen upon us. Verse 28, and the base things of the world, the low things of the world, and things which are despised, which is us, have the Most High chosen, yeah, and the things which are not to bring to naught things that are, which is the coming of a kingdom and to take down Esau Edom's kingdom. Verse 29, that no flesh should glory in his presence. So we can't glory in the presence of the Most High because he have given us his marvelous gifts and earthly vessels. And Yahawashah prayed for this in the book of St. Matthew 11, and 25, it says, at that time, Yahawashah answered and said, I thank thee, O Father, Lord of heaven and earth, because thou hast hid these things from the wise and prudent and have revealed them unto babes. Even so, Father, for so it seemeth good in thy sight. Verse 27, all things are delivered unto me of my Father, and no man knoweth the Son but the Father, neither know of any man the Father save the Son, and he to whomsoever the Son will reveal him. And we have received that revelation as the book of St. John, chapter 15, and verse 15 tells us, and this is the mercy of the Most High, the glory of the Most High that is being seen upon those weak things, to allow Yahawashah to let us know things that Yahawashah learned of the Most High, St. John 15 and 15. Henceforth, I call you not servants, for the servant knoweth not what his Lord doeth, but I have called you friends, for all things that I have heard of my Father, I have made known unto you. And that's the glory of the Most High being seen upon us, to bring us out of that dead state. Ephesians chapter 2 and verse 1, it says, and you have he quickened who were dead in trespasses and sins. Verse 2, where in time past ye walked according to the course of this world, according to the prince of the power of the air, the spirit that now worketh in the children of disobedience. And that spirit, all right, is ultimately in Esau, because he is the ultimate children of disobedience. Esau Edom knows the scriptures. He knows the things that please the Most High. But him being the adversary, he is anti. He is going against everything that he knows. He is going against the Most High at a high level. Verse 3, it says, among whom also we all had our conversation in time past in the lust of our flesh, fulfilling the desires of the flesh and of the mind, and were by nature the children of wrath, even as others. The ultimate children of wrath is Esau. And that falls upon the lot of 2/3 of our people because they're conformed to Esau, Edom's world. They have been blinded by the power of the God of this world. Verse 4, but the Most High, who is rich in mercy, and that mercy is bestowed upon us. For his great love, wherewith he loved us, being the hopeful elect. Verse 5, even when we were dead in sin, he quickened us together. Meaning he made us alive together with HaMashiach. By grace are ye saved, by the favor of the Lord, which is one word to describe grace. We are going to be what? Saved, Lord willing, we endure unto the end. Verse 6, and have raised us up together and made us sit together in heavenly places in HaMashiach Yahawashah, which is this truth. Verse 7, that in the ages to come, and we are in those ages to come right now, he might shew his exceeding riches of his grace and his kindness towards us through HaMashiach Yahawashah. And everything is done through our Lord and Savior Yahawashah, because he is that mediator. Verse 8, for by grace are ye saved through faith, and not that of yourselves. It is the gift of the Most High. So we didn't do anything to receive these gifts. Verse 9 tells us, not of works, lest any man should boast. So that's why all the glorification goes to the Most High. Everything is done for the glorification of the Most High. That glory is being seen upon us because we have been risen out of that dust, out of that confused state, to stand upon our feet due to that light shining in our lives to condemn this current system. So Lord willing, I pray that this made sense and that this was edifying. All things are done for the glorification of the Most High. Shalom, DTA.